Hi guys, welcome to my channel. If you guys would like to see how to do this look, please keep watching. Thank you. So I'm starting off with the Too Faced Born This Way a medium to full coverage foundation in the color Porcelain, and I'm using my beauty sponge and evenly patting all over the face just to get a silky smooth flawless look. I really love this foundation. It's extremely buildable, so if you want to just go for a day-to-day look, you can do one layer, which I'm doing in this for this video, or you can go for the full glam and pack it on. So I'm just going to be quickly going over my brows. If you guys want a full length tutorial on how to do these brows, then comment below. I'm using the BH Cosmetics Flawless Brow Trio in the color medium. So I'm going to be using the Too Faced Stardust palette by Vegas May, and I'm using the color Millennial all over the lid. I'm going to just be packing this on and blending until I get the desired look that I'm trying to achieve. If you can go for a more glam look, I'm doing more of a subtle look. Make sure to take breaks in between patting it on to blend. You don't want to get too much eyeshadow on there before blending, because then it gets hard to once you have so much on there. I'm also going in with the BH Cosmetics brush in the number 5, and I'm just going to go ahead and use that same color Millennial under my waterline and just blending it out. I'm going to blend out with the base shadow brush from Real Techniques. I like to do this just so that we don't have any harsh lines. I'm going back into the Stardust palette and picking up the color Showgirl with the BH Cosmetics brush in the 103 and just patting it on to the center of my upper lid. I'm going to be doing a really light highlight and contour, and I'm going to be using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Cream Kit in light. And I'm going to start off by using the banana shade under my eyes, the center of my face, forehead, and also right below my cheekbone. I'm using a beauty sponge and the Tarte Mercula oil, not sure how to say that correctly, and just adding a few drops to the sponge and dabbing it on the places that I just highlighted. Then I'm just gonna blend. I like to blend out my highlight before I do the contour. It's all personal preference. If you prefer to put it all on the face before, it's all up to you. I just feel like it kind of meshes together when you do it all at once. Now I'm using the shade Light Sculpt from the Contour Cream Kit, and I'm just outlining the outer rim of my face and also my cheekbones, just to add some depth to the face. I'm just doing the same thing on the other side. To sculpt, I'm using the Jane Ardell camouflage brush in the number 10. To blend, I'm using the e.l.f. small stipple brush, and I absolutely love this brush. I think I only paid like $3 for this brush, and it's literally the best brush to contour with. It just blends so flawlessly, as you can see. Just keep blending, just keep blending, just keep blending. After I'm done blending, I like to go in with the beauty sponge just to make sure there's no harsh lines. Then I'm going to go in with the banana shade from the powder contour kit and just put it in the places that I highlighted before with the cream. I can't believe I'm still doing this. Myself a month ago that I've been through with this. I'm looking at my phone and wondering if you're home. I'm kind of tipsy, I ain't trying to sleep alone. Somebody told me that some other girl was. I'm using the shade Fawn to go back over the cream contour. Anytime I use a cream highlight or contour, I like to go over it with the powder just so that it sets and it lasts all day. I will be forever obsessed with L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara. It just does such an evenly pretty layer of mascara. It doesn't clump and I just love it. I rarely wear false lashes, but I will be making a full glam tutorial and I'll include false lashes, so keep a lookout. I'm going back under the waterline to add more of the millennial color under, just to make it a little darker. I'm using the Jane Ardell Complete Highlighter and just dabbing it on the tops of my cheekbones. Again, blending it out with my beauty sponge. I'm using the Becker Shimmering Skin Perfector in the shade Moonstone and just going over where I just highlighted on my cheekbone to add a little more shimmer. And this is the final look. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe to my channel and look out for upcoming videos. Bye!